While Percy was away, Terrence had done all the shunting in the yard. Adaptable, he boasted. That's what my owner says I am. Go anywhere, do anything. That's me. Take my advice and scrap your rails. Broaden your outlook, like me. Pah, said Percy. Me? Plow a field? I'd prefer to stay on my rails, thank you. Steam engines did plow once upon a time, Terrence chuckled, and ran on roads. The engines remembered Trevor and had to admit Terrence was right. Repairs to Mavis took longer than expected, and Toby became used to trundling off to the quarry each morning. Because of his small water tank, his driver and fireman had arranged with the quarry manager that they should bring loaded cars down from Farquhar at lunchtime instead of later in the day. It saved time, too, for Toby would otherwise have needed an extra journey to fill his water tank. This way, he delivered the cars and got water in one visit. Time passed, and the weather became colder with hard frosts during the night. They didn't worry Toby. His fire kept him nice and warm, and he puffed happily to and fro arranging cars, taking them down to the yard, and bringing back empty ones. One particularly cold night, the ground froze solid, and even Toby felt chilly. Brrr, he shivered as he left the shed and set out, light engine, along the line towards the quarry. When the ground freezes, it swells, and at the road crossing where Mavis had had her accident, frost had swollen the earth and the ruts beside the rails so much that Toby's wheels were lifted clean off the track. He exclaimed. What's happening? Whoa, Toby said his driver at once and put the brakes on as hard as he dared. Shakily, Toby came to a stop with all six wheels firmly on the roadway. Oh dear, he said, looking down at the grass verge in front of him. Now what? The fireman jumped down. No problem, he said. With care, we can have you back on the rails in no time. I don't see how, said Toby sadly. Directed by the fireman, the driver carefully reversed Toby along the ruts his wheels had made. At last, with a thud and a jolt, he felt rails safely beneath his wheels once more. He heaved a sigh of relief. Well done, Toby, said his fireman. Now I'll spread a few hot ashes from your fire along there so it doesn't happen again. Then we can get safely up to the quarry and no one will ever be the wiser. But they reckoned without Sir Topham Hatt. When Mavis was home after being mended, he came to see the engines. What's this I hear, Toby? He asked. Trying to be a traction engine, are you? Toby blushed, but Sir Topham Hatt wasn't cross. Toby told him about Terrence. Sir Topham Hatt laughed. If I were you, he said, I'd leave the roads to what they were made for. You stay on the rails. You'll find them much more comfortable. Toby, the tram engine, was quick to agree.